guys like you and me, we're just the losers who keep waiting to be seen. Right? I mean, no one seems to care or stops to notice that we're there, so we get lost in the in-between. But if you can somehow keep them thinking of me and make me more than an abandoned memory, well, that means we matter too. It means someone will see that you are there. No one deserves to be forgotten. No one deserves to fade away. No one should come and go and have no one know he was ever even here. No one deserves to disappear, to disappear, disappear. It's true. Even if you've always been that barely in the background kind of guy, you still matter. And even if you're somebody who can't escape the feeling that the world's passed you by,
you still matter.
If you never get around to doing some remarkable thing, that doesn't mean
that you're not worth remembering.
Think of the people who need to know.
They need to know.
So you need to show them
that no one deserves to be forgotten. No one deserves to be forgotten. No one deserves to fade away, to fade away. No one should flicker out or have any doubt that it matters that they are here. No one deserves,
no one deserves to disappear, to disappear, disappear.
Calling it the Connor Project.
The Connor Project?
A student group dedicated to keeping Connor's memory alive, to showing that everybody should matter.
We have to do this. Not just for Connor, for everyone.
'Cause no one deserves to be forgotten.
No one deserves,
no one deserves to fade away.
We're calling it the Connor Project.
The Connor Project?
Imagine a major online presence.
A massive fundraising drive.
And for the kickoff event, an all-school memorial assembly.
I didn't realize Connor meant this much to people.
Oh, Evan, this is wonderful.
No one deserves to be forgotten.
No one deserves to fade away.
No one deserves to disappear.
No one deserves to disappear.
No one should flicker out or have any doubt that it matters.
Disappear.
So you found a place where the grass is greener, and you jump the fence to the other side. Is it good? Are they giving you a world I could never provide?
I'm not doing this. I'm done.
You can't just stop now.
I don't think I can live with this anymore.
What about my parents?
No more emails.
How can you do this to them?
No more Connor Project. No more Orchard.
After everything they've done for you, they need you.
Need me for what? To keep lying to them?
That lie is the only thing that's keeping them together.
That's not true.
Oh, really? So they seem like a pretty happy family when you met them?
I don't want to lie anymore.
And what about Zoe?
Zoe said she wants me.
Right.
Yes, she likes me for who I am.
Except you didn't happen to mention that everything you've told her, it's all been one big fucking lie, did you? Oh, you left that part out.
So then what? What if I did tell her the truth?
She'll hate
you. No, maybe she would understand. Maybe everyone would understand.
Everyone will hate
you. Not if I could explain it,
right,
you
back
know?
To where you started.
No,
I want to
be done with it.
Nobody, yeah. Nothing,
a I'm ready to be done with it!
If you really believe that, then why are you standing here talking to yourself? Again. You think you're going to turn around all of a sudden and start telling everyone the truth? You can't even tell yourself the truth.
What are you talking about?
How'd you break your arm? How'd you break your arm, Evan?
I fell.
Really? Is that what happened?
Yes! I was... I lost my grip and then I fell, so...
Did you fall? Or did you let go? You can get rid of me whenever you want. Connor Project, the Orchard, but then all that you're going to be left with is you. End of May or early June, this picture-perfect afternoon, we should drive the winding country road, grab a scoop at Alamo, and then we're there. Think about it.